Thank you all very much, and thank you for coming to Texas. I've been like hopeless causes, and so now I get to talk about Medicaid in 7 minutes. So that's pretty hopeless. Not to mention that Medicaid is pretty hopeless. The point about Medicaid is that it's such a double-edged sword. And as advocates, it's putting us all in an ethical dilemma. Now for me, this keeps me up at night, because on the one hand, I'm fighting like the devil to do away with Medicaid. And on the other hand, we have to fight together to preserve it. Okay, well, what do we do with that? Where do we put this? You know, this creates some kind of dynamic tension in our personal bodies and our organizations. But Medicaid is what is at the root of our current system of healthcare apartheid in this country. Now, it's a very complicated system, and the whole system of social insurance is, I think, deliberately complex so that nobody really understands it. But Medicaid, more than Medicare, is very much the opposite of Medicare. So when people misspeak and they say Medicaid instead of Medicare, this is really serious, because Medicare, it doesn't really care how much money you make. Medicaid does. And so under Medicaid, if you're going to be eligible for Medicaid, you cannot work. You cannot work. You cannot have any assets in the bank. I mean, in many states, you can't own a home, you can't own a car, you can't own all kinds of things, because those would put you over the federal poverty limit and make you have more assets than Medicaid eligibility would allow. So where does that leave you for health care? Okay, so it's really the thumb that holds us down. And who gets Medicaid? Right now, it's mostly single women and people with disabilities. So who are those? The two most devalued populations in this country. So all my life, I've been fighting for the rights of people with disabilities before I discovered that I'm a woman. And I have an awful lot in common with 50% of people in the United States who are women. And I realized, that there's a lot more than just disability to fight about. And I realized that we have an awful lot in common on a whole lot of issues. And so this issue about being forced not to work was a real injustice. And why? Because of Medicaid. Because there's no other way to get health care. Now, only about 50% of physicians accept Medicaid because of the very low reimbursement rates. At least here in Texas, in Harris County or Houston, we have very, very long waiting lists. And there are very substandard services that are available in Medicaid. You have to wait about 6 months to get the result of a cancer screening test, for example. Now that's gone way down since Doctors for Change has come into being and advocated for shorter waiting times to get test results, among many other things that that group has done. And I recommend that you talk with Catherine King about that. She was in the back of the room there, but they've done a tremendous amount of work to improve things. But it's still a system that's definitely substandard. It forces people to maintain their poverty status, prohibits work, prohibits savings, and discriminates against women and people with disabilities. And moreover, it has an institutional bias. It's much easier to get somebody committed to an institution because of a disability, or because they're getting old, or because they don't want to have to mow their lawn anymore. I mean, for some ridiculous reasons, it's much easier, at least in the state of Texas, to commit them to an institution or a nursing home than it is to get them home care. So those are all the negatives. Now, we've got to try to preserve this apartheid system. Okay, well, the reality is, if we don't preserve it, people are gonna die. Because that's how it's set up. That's how it's set up. Hundreds of millions of people, no, hundreds of thousands of people in this country are going literally to die on the street if we don't have the Medicaid system. And the solution is going to be networking. We've talked a lot about networking so far today. And Maria Palacios, who I asked to come and help me with this, from the Houston Center for Independent Living, has the brochures. Now, can we start getting those brochures around? Maria, I'd like to get like 10 to each table, because I think that's...
I have them right here. Thank you for your support.
Yeah. Okay, why don't you just look at this. This is for our campaign by a group called ADAPT. And I was so pleased to hear that Veronica went there. I'm sorry, Vanessa went there. And Katie, I think you've been to ADAPT Actions. This is like the Black Panthers of the disability rights movement. These are the guys who go out and get arrested on the steps of Washington and everywhere else. I support these guys 100%. They're the ones who are really out there to fight for disability rights. Their current campaign is to get in-home health care services or in-home attendant care services. They want it. The CLASS Act, which was part of the PPACA, the ACA, but it got X'd out, so it's no longer there. But they're still trying to get more, to get rid of the institutional bias. Now they've got this campaign going called My Medicaid Matters, where they're trying to get personal stories of people on Medicaid to get the word out there why Medicaid is what's currently saving their life. And what we're trying to do now is to recruit collaborators, co-signers on this campaign, and we're asking people in every community in the United States, which is where every person who's on Medicaid lives, every community in this country has someone on Medicaid. We're asking every community to come forward, every advocacy group that cares about people who are on Medicaid, to sign on to this campaign so that we can show the numbers that are needed to preserve it while we're reforming the system and trying to get rid of it, which we're not going to talk about right now. But what they want to do, the goals of this campaign, are to educate. This is a Texas campaign. It's gonna go national. ADAPT is a national organization. But their goals are to educate individuals about what Medicaid is and what policymakers can do to preserve it, to monitor and stop the damaging cuts and the block grants and the waivers and the caps and all the other things that are going to really injure people and literally cause people to die. When they take away their Medicaid, and that's already happening in Texas. Their other goal is to advocate for access to decent health care and community-based services and supports, and to tell their leaders that deficit reductions and sustainable budgets must use a balanced approach that includes new revenues and does not rely on cuts alone. That's what happened in Texas. They just cut, they did not generate any new revenues. Texas and Mississippi, by the way, hold up the bottom when it comes to Medicaid and any kind of social support program. Texas has no social, no income tax, no state income or local income tax. So that's why it's such a nice place for businesses to do business, but it also offers very little in the way of social support services. So that's why we're suffering so badly. And when you hear that Texas has a balanced budget, well, the truth of it is that the last session of our legislature, which only meets every 2 years, passed an 18-month budget. You didn't hear that in the debates, did you?
Yeah.
Well, okay, 18-month budget meant that there's still another about $5 billion in cuts that have to be made in order to make it to the next session of the legislature. You know where those cuts are gonna come from. They're gonna come out of Medicaid, and they're gonna come out of education. That's Texas, okay. So the strategies is to use the My Medicaid Matters campaign to describe why Medicaid program is important to you and to your family. To use the phrase, kind of, Medicaid hurts people. And to say also that it hurts business too. Medicaid generates a lot of jobs. This is really a fact. It's part of the fabric of our economy. There are an awful lot of therapists, physicians, home care workers that rely on Medicaid funding to provide their services. So it will cut jobs. We have to protect the Medicaid program. That slashing Medicaid means lost jobs, and that Medicaid has broad public support. The public wants to maintain what we call the social safety net. So we can rely on that. We are really appealing to the broad support that even, I hate to say this word, it hurts, Tea Partiers want. They really do want it. When you talk to them one-on-one, they really want the social safety net. They don't want to have people dying on their front porch, which is what's going to happen if we cut Medicaid. So these are some of the strategies that we're using right now in the Texas program, soon to go national, called My Medicaid Matters. If in your locality you would like to join with us, please talk to Maria in the back, give her your email address, and let her know about the support that your organization could lend to this campaign. Thank you very much.